Boca.
Go check out igsky.com. If you're looking for some cheap FIFA 16 coins, use Rossi for an 8% discount. Enjoy the video. Hello guys, Mr. Rossi1990 here. It's going to be another one of these transfer rumor videos. So today we've got a few people to cover. Not as many as I would like, but it's kind of at the stage of the moment where teams are starting to play their preseason friendlies, or they're halfway through their preseason friendlies now. And not a lot of transfer activity is happening. More the fact that people are just playing games and checking out their squad to see what they need rather than spending loads of cash. You'll see it probably develop a lot more just before the season starts into when the season actually starts, in my opinion. But the first one on today's episode, if you can smash a like button, by the way, that'd be absolutely amazing. And apologies for not uploading in a few days. It's been unbelievably hot in the UK, and I just don't want to do videos where I'm just going to be literally dying in front of you guys. So hopefully you guys can appreciate that. I know other few YouTubers didn't do a few videos as well, but my God, it was so hot. I didn't want to be in front of my computer. So hopefully you guys can appreciate and respect that. But anyway, first one is going to be Leroy Sané. Now, this one's been one of them ones which has been in the background a little bit and is coming into effect now. You'll probably see this one progressing over the next couple of days, maybe in 24 hours, to be honest. And apparently he's already asked Schalke to leave, so that's the first step. Manchester City is his likely destination, because apparently Bayern Munich have pulled out of the deal, thinking he's going to cost them too much, or they don't need him, whichever is. I don't think they said they didn't need him, but you know, a guy like him, so much potential, why wouldn't you just take him? But Man City look like they're going to get their man. I think Pep Guardiola is a big fan of him from his Bundesliga days, of course. And he's a good player in real life. Very young, still got a lot of potential, a lot of hype around him. Definitely a label of wonder kid for sure. But Manchester City look like they will probably get this guy in the coming weeks for sure. Okay, so the next transfer is unbelievable. Apparently, tonight, Manchester United and Juventus have agreed a 120 million euros, I want to say, bid for Paul Pogba. Now, this one's been obviously in a number of these videos I've been doing, but tonight, just literally about 10 minutes before I'm doing this video, I've had to actually add this in, so it might seem a little bit weird jumping ship, because I wasn't going to put this in because it was kind of the same story, Pogba potentially going to Manchester United. I've been hearing about it for days, but according to some sources, some big sources, it's a done deal pretty much. Pogba's apparently agreed personal terms. A fee has been agreed. Wouldn't be surprised if you see this one confirmed within the next 48 hours, which is absolutely ridiculous. 120 million euros, about 100 million pounds, say. Crazy money. What do you guys make of that one? Let me know in the comment section below. The next one, we got another player who is apparently on his way back to a previous club. It's Mario Götze going back to Dortmund. Now, I think this would be a good move for him if it does actually happen. Apparently tonight, again, according to some sources, this deal is very, very close to being completed, even though I'm pretty sure I heard Bayern Munich's manager say, well, not their manager, their owner or their president or whatever, say that he wasn't going to do anything with Götze for a couple of weeks or something. They're going to keep hold of him, see how he does. But apparently it could be a done deal about probably the same time as Pogba. These two deals could go through within the next 48 hours. Holy shit! The next player is a little bit of a strange one for me personally, because Arsenal have been linked with a few strikers recently, but I didn't expect him to be linked with Icardi. I don't know too much about him, if I'm being totally honest. I know he's got a really nice FIFA card there, actually. Two-star skill moves isn't nice, but all-round good use of blue team of the season, of course. And I think he looks like the type of striker Arsenal need on his FIFA stats-wise. He's got a decent pace, he's got good dribbling, good shooting. He's an all-round really good card, actually. He's got good physical as well. But I can't judge it too much for not watching him play a lot in real life. I've seen him a few times, but I couldn't exactly judge him in massively, if that makes sense. Hopefully you guys can understand that. But I still think Giroud's a good striker, so maybe I've got no knowledge of football whatsoever, because some people think Giroud's crap. But I think he's genuinely a decent striker. So I think Arsenal do need to sign another striker, but you know, you want him to sign the Higuain or Lacazette rather than maybe an Icardi. My personal opinion, what do you guys make of that one? The next player is a done deal, and it's Adam Bogdan, the Liverpool goalkeeper. He's gone on loan to Wigan. Now, I think a lot of Liverpool people, when they originally signed Bogdan, was hoping that he would actually be quite a good goalkeeper. He's made some howlers for Liverpool. I think in one game in particular, he had an absolute horror show. But he's gone on loan to Wigan, obviously a new promoted team into the Championship. Probably get a lot of game time there. Hopefully develop into a goalkeeper Liverpool want him to be. If not, then maybe Liverpool can see him going out in the near future. I think it's a loan deal, but I don't know if it's an option to buy or anything. But there you go. That is what it is. The next player is actually going to be a guy who has gone to Liverpool. And this is Ragnar Klavan guy. I don't know anything about this guy. Apart from he had apparently a good game for Estonia. And he also had a really good game against Liverpool, apparently, for Augsburg, the team they've signed him from. I think it's like £4.5 million. I see him as a squad rotational player more than a starter, personally. I think it's kind of to replace Skrtel, if that makes sense. If it makes total sense, really. Looks quite solid on his FIFA card there. It's not a card I actually think I've ever seen before. Like, I've probably packed him and discarded him. He's that type of player. He's a non-shiny and whatever. He's got high medium work rates on FIFA, but that doesn't mean he's got them in real life. It just irritates me. I don't know about you guys, but every time I see a defender with high attacking work rate, I think, why? Why? Unless you're Barcelona. But the next player is Grant Hanley, and this one is apparently moving ever so closer. Apparently now has agreed a fee to go to Newcastle. He's agreed personal terms. A 5.5 million fee has been agreed with Blackburn. He just needs to pass his medical, and this one could actually be confirmed possibly tomorrow, as you see in this video, maybe even tonight, depending on how things go in the medical. People are failing medicals at the moment, so you just never know. He's a solid championship centre-back. I don't know if he's Premier League quality type of player, so maybe he's a type of player who can probably get you into the Premier League in the squad that Newcastle got. They're not going to have any problems, in my opinion, to at least get top six. And they're probably going to win the league, let's be honest. They still kept hold of some of their top players already, and they don't even look like going, a few of them. People like Jonjo Shelvey in particular. He's going to be unbelievable in the championship. But Grant Hanley, I think it's a decent signing for them. You know, not a fantastic centre-back in any way, shape or form, but a very, very solid one. He'll do your job. He'll do the nitty-gritty. He'll do exactly what you want him to do. And he's just a good player, and honestly, it's a good signing for a championship team. Let's put it that way. We'll move to the next player now, which is going to be Franco Vasquez. Now, this is actually meant to be a hero card, but for some reason, I couldn't get an image of a hero card. It's going to be a gold card on your screen. He's moved to Sevilla for, I think it's like 8 million or something like that. He's actually a really good player in this game, but he's the opposite to what I've just been saying about the defenders, having high, medium. He's got medium high for a centre forward. I just don't understand it personally. Typical false nine, you could say. Maybe he wants to play more of a centre midfielder, a bit like a Wayne Rooney, possibly. But he looks like a really good card on there. Again, don't know too much about him, but he's got his move to Sevilla. Sevilla actually making some decent signings. I think they bought a couple more players as well. We covered a few weeks ago. I can't remember what he's called. One of them was Japanese, I think. We'll move to the next player now, which is going to be Gino Wijnaldum. I can't see his name. It's almost like a tongue twister. But apparently his move to Liverpool is edging closer as well. Liverpool look like they're active in the transfer market for a couple of players now. I don't know if he'll fit into their team exactly. I don't know exactly where they'll play that type of player, but it's almost inevitable that someone like him will leave Newcastle. Him and Sissoko, if the money is put up for them, almost inevitably going to go, because I don't think they want to play in the championship, especially Sissoko. He's been a right dickhead on Twitter, to be fair. I understand a guy's wanting to move, possibly, when your team gets relegated and you feel as if you're a better player than that, but you were part of that team which got relegated, and he didn't play well last season. I watched a lot of Newcastle's games. He played well for France, but you got to play well for your club. And putting a 35 million price tag on him, I found that hilarious. He's not worth that, in my opinion. But if somebody pays that, then Newcastle have done an absolute worldie. But Wijnaldum is a different story. I think he is probably worth the price tag Newcastle put on him. He's like 20, 25 million pounds. And Liverpool are actively pursuing it. I think Tottenham were interested, but apparently they've pulled out of it. But that makes sense. I think Liverpool will probably end up getting him, if anybody. The next player is going to be a guy who's actually possibly involved in the deal for Wijnaldum. And that's Lucas Lieva, possibly going the other way to Newcastle from Liverpool. Now, this will be an unbelievable signing if Newcastle pull this one. Obviously, Newcastle's manager, Rafa Benitez, worked at Liverpool, knows a lot of Liverpool people, so he may actually have a little bit more of a pull than what other people do. It's had to be Rafa Benitez. It's probably big enough for most people. But if he gets Lucas Lieva, it'll be a top signing for a championship team. Absolutely. He can still do it in the Premier League. Maybe not the topest of teams. Maybe Liverpool is a little bit too step for him. But I think he could easily do it in one of the promoted teams, some of the lower down kind of Premier League teams. He could definitely do it in the championships. So if Newcastle get him, then fair play to him. Their team will just get stronger and stronger. The next player is also a done deal, and that is Jake Forster Kaski, or Kaski. Don't know exactly how to say his name, to be honest. He's actually apparently a really good player in real life. Was on loan at MK Dons last season. I can't remember who he's owned by. I think it's Brighton. But he's gone on loan to Rotherham this time, another championship club. He seems to be finding himself in the championship a little bit. And he's meant to be a hot prospect. I remember buying him on Football Manager one year, and he was labelled a wonder kid after a while. But it doesn't seem to be happening for him for whatever reason. A couple of loans here and there. Maybe he'll finally get his club and he'll settle down in it. You can't. It's all well and good loaning out players, but just loaning them out all the time is going to damage them, in my opinion. He needs to settle down, possibly, but he's still not very old, so he's still got a lot of potential. But we'll move to the next one now, which is going to be James Wilson. He was on loan at Brighton last season. He's linked with a loan move to Fulham this time. He is owned by Manchester United, and apparently Manchester United wanted to ship him out for whatever reason, whether it be a loan or maybe even a permanent deal, depending on what happens. But Fulham are making some good signings, actually. They've made a couple of good signings. So a player like Wilson will fit the bill. Pacey striker. His old team card isn't actually that great. He's a lot better than that in real life. I rate him quite highly in championship kind of terms. I would actually wouldn't mind him at Leeds, if I'm being totally honest, but I can't see that happening. Being a Man U player and all that. But I think Fulham, if they do get him, he'll actually probably work really well with Ross McCormack up front. But at the other stage, he could be the replacement for Ross McCormack because he's still heavily linked to a move away. I think Norwich are interested, Aston Villa, Newcastle were interested at one point, but I think they probably ended that with signing Gale. We move to the next player now, which is going to be this guy right here. You probably know about this guy. He is called Enkodu. He's actually a really good Ultimate Team player because he's got a lot of pace. He is heavily linked, and I mean heavily linked. We move to Spurs, Tottenham, if you will. It's probably going to be a done deal within the next 24 hours. I think a fee has been agreed. Personal terms have been agreed. All good to go. I can imagine this one being done very, very soon. I think it's a good signing. He's got a lot of potential, apparently, in real life. Again, I don't think I've ever seen this guy play. Ever. I don't recognise him. I didn't even know he had a FIFA card until I looked him up and realised he had 92 pace. My God, the pace. But the next player is going to be Robin Van Persie, and he's actually linked, unbelievably, to move to Stoke. Be quite an interesting one, actually, if he pull this one off. Stoke probably do need a striker, actually. They're also in for Berahino, but we have covered that one recently. And I think West Brom are probably going to go in for Berahino as well. So I've left Berahino out of this episode because we cover him a little bit. But Van Persie to Stoke, if that happens, I feel as if he could probably still do it in the Premier League at certain clubs. I don't think he could do it like the Arsenal or the Manchester United anymore. I don't know exactly how well he did for Fenerbahce, but he got himself an informed card at one point, so he can't have been doing too bad. But if Stoke do get their man, he might fit their formation quite well. You know, they've got the nice kind of trio in behind him of the Shaqiris, the Bojans, the Arnautovic. They've got a really nice attacking line. But striker may be a position they could definitely improve on. The next player is going to be Shay Adams. And he's actually linked with a move to Birmingham. Now, this is more of, it's not really a link, actually. It's a Birmingham had a bit rejected for him of 1 million. I think apparently Huddersfield had a bit of about 700k rejected for him. Birmingham upped it to 1 million. That's still been rejected. I'm not too sure what his price is going to be. I can't imagine it being too much. He is apparently a very, very, very good talent. I have seen him play a few times. He scored a number of goals, actually, for Sheffield United. And he does look like a good talent, to be fair. So he could get his move to a higher leagued club, obviously, going into the Championship. But I don't know how much they're going to have to pay. Possibly 2 million, maybe 1.5, something like that. Can't imagine it being too much more than a million, if I'm being totally honest. But the next player is this guy right here, which is actually a guy for Chelsea. He's gone on loan to Crewe until January. So only half season loan. But he's I literally have no idea who this is. Again, he's obviously a young Chelsea prospect. He's got good pace. He's only a 55 rated, but with 93 pace, it's pretty crazy. Actually, for a 55 rated, he's got all right stats, hasn't he? 93 pace, 56 dribbling is decent for a 55 rated, to be fair. Even though it's not great overall. But he looks like an all right player. Crewe, I think Crewe League One, I should say. So he's not gone too far down, if that makes sense. He's gone into League One, and hopefully he can push on his career there. But the final player now, before I completely lose my voice is actually going unbelievably, is Nasher Chadli. And he's apparently linked with Swansea. Now, he's a type of player who's probably on the fringes of Tottenham, but he's actually still got a very good career, I could say. I think he's a good player. I really do rate him quite highly. Obviously, Tottenham have got better players. Now, Tottenham being linked to this French left-winger guy possibly pushes Chadli down the pecking order a tad more. So if he does get his move to Swansea, wouldn't be a bad thing for his career, if I'm being totally honest. Swansea looking to obviously improve their team from last season. But that is going to be it for this video, guys. If you have enjoyed it, a like would be fantastic. Unfortunately, no Leeds links this episode because there's so much. They're getting linked to players, but then it's almost getting like ended the day after. They're linked with the Conor McLaughlin, I think he's called, the right back for Fleetwood, who played for Northern Ireland. Then they were linked with Rhys Wibara. He was on a free transfer, was at Wigan last season. But then that got said to know about. So I really don't know who Leeds are linked with at the moment. But sometimes that's a good thing. Sometimes you look at the Twitter and they're not getting linked with anybody. And then they just sign somebody out of the blue. And it's all well and good. But you need to sign some players because they're bloody struggling. But if you have enjoyed this video, like it would be fantastic. If you're new around here, do not be afraid to subscribe. I'll catch you next time. And bye-bye. Boo!